Let's talk about the five different types of data analyst portfolios. A good portfolio can be the thing that helps you land a job as a data analyst, especially as a beginner, and not having the proper portfolio can stop you. And of course, the projects are critical as well, but everyone knows that, and there are tutorials all over YouTube. But the actual portfolio itself is often overlooked, and it's really important. So let's talk about the five data analyst portfolios and see which one is the best for you. Let's get started. The first one is a Kaggle portfolio. Now, Kaggle is not really a portfolio website in itself. It's basically a community platform for data science, where you can, for example, enter in competitions, find free datasets to work with, and engage in discussions with other people. But you can also put your data projects there on Kaggle, and all you have to do is just upload it as a notebook or a dataset if that's what you're looking to publish, of course. All of this is entirely free, and you can have as many projects here as you want. But is it the most professional thing? Well, not really. Many people use this as a way to host the projects themselves, but it doesn't mean that it's the perfect portfolio that represents you in the best way, because that's exactly what a portfolio is supposed to do. You don't get to speak to the recruiter first, your portfolio does. So if you have a bad portfolio, chances are that you're not even gonna make it past the first scan. The next one is GitHub. Now, GitHub is very similar to Kaggle in some ways. It has many features, but for our purposes, it's a platform allowing developers to store and manage their code. If you come from a programming background, you're almost certainly familiar with this one. GitHub can also be used for data analyst portfolios, or any in data science for that matter. It offers some additional functionalities that Kaggle doesn't really offer, and free of charge as well. Create an account and then you can get started. You can then upload your projects and just link your GitHub profile or the project in itself, for example on LinkedIn or in your resume or wherever you need it. GitHub is also a great option, but it kinda replaces Kaggle. It doesn't really add much to it. So let's take a look at the next one. Another type of portfolio is one that's relatively new. There are a lot of websites now that specifically target people in data science or other fields and help them build a portfolio fast. Now, it's not always the best solution for everybody, but it's definitely a quick one to set up. The website datascienceportfolio.io offers this service, and you can showcase them on a relatively personal portfolio website. It's still going to be under their domain, but it does look very, very good. And I actually want to give a shout out to this platform. I haven't used it myself, but I've only heard good things about it. This is how a portfolio or a profile looks like. You have a profile picture, a name, a job title, and the location, some social medias like LinkedIn or Twitter or Instagram, and also an about section where you can put some info about yourself. Finally, you have like a skill section where you can put in some information about your skills, and then it shows your projects on the other side, the key skills of each project, as well as a brief description of what the project entails, and of course also an image, which is really important. You want to catch the attention of the recruiter or the hiring manager, and you do that by making it look interesting and nice. They've also built some sort of community platform where you can see other people's projects, and I do think that your projects could show up there too, but I'm not entirely sure. You'd have to look into that. Next, LinkedIn can actually work as a powerful portfolio itself too. And even if you have a portfolio already, LinkedIn can significantly improve your chances of getting a job. Because even if you're not able to, you know, fully optimize your LinkedIn profile like your actual portfolio and include as many things as you would like to, it's still a place where a lot of people hang out. Recruiters, companies, everyone is on LinkedIn. And if you haven't already optimized your LinkedIn profile, it's definitely time to do so. Put the job description or aspiring data analyst if you want to. Highlight some of the key skills, but do keep things short. It's also important to realize that your LinkedIn should be focusing on one goal. Don't try to become a data analyst and a chef at the same time. You're just going to be miserable and not land a job at all. Nobody wants to hire a candidate that wants to be a data analyst 50% of the time and a chef 50% of the time. Unless it's a really special role that you're applying to and it's like a data analyst chef or something, but I'm just being general here. There are always exceptions. So with LinkedIn, you can also add a project section. Simply click on add section on your profile, find projects, and then you'll be asked to input the name of the project, a brief description of the project, some of the key skills used for this project, and a media like an image to visualize it, as well as any other details you want to add. And if you did it as a part of the course or like a bootcamp or something, you can also put that too. It's actually a really great feature, and if you haven't used this, you're really missing out, because if a recruiter looks at your LinkedIn profile, chances are that they're never even going to click and head over to your GitHub or your website. So with a project project section, you get a free bonus opportunity to get recognized. But there's still one type of portfolio that I haven't even mentioned yet, and it's the personal portfolio. Now, all of these are pretty personal, right? So what do I mean? I'm talking about a standalone portfolio on your own separate website. Now, I don't personally recommend starting with this right away, as it does require some additional effort. If you do it right, it can definitely be better and look more professional than the other alternatives. I've seen some really great portfolios that look like this. There are more opportunities here with a personal portfolio, and it's the most customizable option because it's your own website. You can do whatever you want. But as you can notice, there are also more risks here, more places where you can screw things up and make a mistake. So to build your personal portfolio on your own website, you can either build it using a no-code solution like WordPress or Wix, but if you do have some coding experience, you can also build the website yourself from scratch. I think the easier the better, because you're not really trying to show off your skills in web development, so it could be a waste of time. Wix is a pretty good option that I've actually used myself, because they also offer great portfolio templates. You can just go to their website, select portfolio, and find one that you like, and then you can just modify it to your liking. You can then keep your projects on Kaggle or GitHub, and just have a simple front end on Wix describing the projects, like a summary of the things like we saw on dataportfolio.io. The question I often get asked is, do I need a domain? And it depends. You can definitely use the free domains provided by Wix or WordPress or any other site, and that's completely fine. You can also buy a domain, for example, on Namecheap or GoDaddy. Just head over there and put in whatever domain you want, for example, your name. Buying a domain can be very affordable. It's often only a couple of bucks per year, but it's completely up to you. You definitely don't need one. The main advantage might be SEO and being easily recognized if you're doing consulting or freelancing, but if you're just gonna send this website to recruiters, I don't really think it matters that much. What do you think? Now, I also have a full-length video on how to build one of these portfolios for data analysts right here, and I think you'll find it helpful as well. And that's all for this video. Thanks for watching.